So before you leave the main area, which is the Cradle map, try to take everything that you can pack into your base and then go. By the way, before you leave, if you have more than one walker, you can send it to the lobby. For example, like this pretty thing over here. Enter it and choose transfer to the lobby. Then you have to wait 2 minutes and it'll actually be out on the lobby. Let me see if I can move while transferring, yeah. And that is my stiletto. Yeah, for now. Yeah, you can move while transferring it. Okay, let's have some fun then. Let's go down with the spider. Actually, I built the stiletto and I want to share a few tips with the stiletto and the base and the base packing and some other crazy mechanics. Okay, sure, sure. The spider walker is very good at mountain climbing, as you can see. Sorry for the low FPS. It's also very good at rolling down a mountain. Ah, don't worry, it'll be fine. It's a very, very resilient one. Now, when you build a bigger walker like that, be sure to make the... Let me see where it is. The walker tools, the walker climber. So let me show you what exactly it is. It should be over here somewhere. I don't know, I always forget where it is, the walker climber. Okay, it's over here. And what this thing does is actually amazing. See that thing over there? Only you can use it and your clan members probably. Hey, that was a bit laggy, but you get the general idea. The point of that is that you can board your walker in just a fraction of a second, see? Now, because I'm very, very heavy, it takes a little while longer. Okay, let's transfer some cargo over here. As you can see, in my walker, I stored some of the most important things and some of the things that I wanted to be close to me. Now, when you build a base, you can either make it a little larger, but depending on your walker, it may not fit in it because it's a limited space. Again, the FPS will get better after I leave this area. Usually I like to keep some stuff over there in the first chest. And as you can see, I have the crafting stations, the stomping station, which is producing water for me right now. Get over there, you. I mean, he's so fat, it will actually affect your speed and your climbing speed. I can't go there because I'm too fat. Okay, then let's put all the stones down here. And maybe some of the ashes. I want to show you what I have in the other chests. And yeah, while you're traveling, this thing will actually produce water, so you will never run out of water while traveling. Okay, and now I have a few chests over here with random materials. Also, if you want to make the earth wax, you just need to put the palm leaves into the stomping station. Hey, close the door. I don't want a monkey to kill me when I'm doing this, because this is basically the game after 20 hours of playing. So I have a lot of water here in my base. I have water on me, the bag can hold 70. I have a lot of water on my stiletto. And also some other things regarding the stiletto, because some people might not know what to do. So when you build a stiletto, it doesn't have the levers on it. So you have to build the levers. Remember, when you unlock the stiletto, it has the steering levers over there. And that's a thing you can build. Let me see. Parts, tools. Where are those? Maybe because I build them, I can't build them again. Oh, here they are in the interactables. I forget because I only used that one. So you can build the steering levers, I think, anywhere on your little ship. So I think I can build them over there or over here if you wanted. And put the ballistas up there. That actually might be a better idea, to put them up there. Put them something down here in the middle and then put ballistas on top of there. And some other ballistas and some other slingshots, rupu repeaters and some other stuff on the sides. Yeah, that might actually work. So this is kind of how you do the big walker. Sure, we can recruit. Sorry about this, but sometimes you have to stop the video for the obvious reasons. I recommend you start, if you want to start a clan, recruit straight away. Because the more people you have, the more people that can help you build stuff, and you know, it'll be a little better if you join a little group of 4 people, 7 people, something like that. Now, let me show you some other thing. Before I pack the huge thingy, I want to show you another thing about the walkers and how much you can actually customize them in a way. So here I have my hardwood, and my soft materials. It's really funny when I think about it. Now remember, this little thingy, it's incredible. See, this is how fast you can jump on it. So if you are collecting resources, you can jump almost immediately. Now, some of these things... Let me see... As you can see, it says it can be packed on walkers. You can build it on walkers, but there are some things that you can build on your walker. For example, let's say you can build this. So, actually the walker customization is huge, and this will stop people from boarding you, or at least give them a harder times. Now, let's see, this is kind of how the speed is when you want to climb a walker, or how weird and janky it can be. But that's one of the reasons that I put the steering levers over there, so I can actually access it very, very quickly and drive it. So I'll have to play more with it and the walker customizations. You can also put ballistas on them. Yeah, a lot of things you can put on a walker. Actually, we can put 2 ballistas, actually even 3 ballistas if we want, and move these things over here into the back a little bit. That's actually a good location for this boarding thingy. Now, let's go and actually pack the base. I don't want to make this a very, very long video, but this is just a portion of what you can do in the game, and this is a portion what the stiletto can look like. Also, remember, your stiletto has upgrades with materials. You can put some modules in them. For example, I have the bullrush module, which enables me to spawn faster. And if you have weapons and armor on your stiletto or whatever ship you have, when you spawn, you'll spawn with them equipped. So that's even better. So yeah, that's why I'm trying to build a lot of stuff. Now, let me show you some of the weapons actually, because you have the ballistas, the remote ballistas, the repeater. I think you can bundle them on the walkers as well. I'll make more videos and show you later on, so don't worry about that. So now it's time to pack my base, but warning, once you do build a base, if you pack it, that's not going to be editable anymore. So make sure you have all the stuff you need in your base. Okay, now let's go over here again. Let's actually pack the base, because this might be something that people don't really know how to do. So pack the base. Go near the base. Click F. Hello. Okay, the spider walker is over here now. It also said the weight of the... See, this is why the weight of the walker or the walker capability of storage is important. Because it will store your entire base. Now, if you want to unpack the base, basically my base is not modifiable anymore. You can just, you know, put it like this. See? You can put it over there. I mean, you can go to, for example, a location on the map, farm a lot of resources, unpack your base, process them, get some water, and then pack the base again and start running again. Now, this thing can be a little buggy, so be careful. Let's drive it a little bit. I mean, this is the best view on the ship if you want to steer it. Also, if you are wondering what the torque is, as many people might ask that, what is the torque? Well, the torque is the power of the ship, and you can actually store it using batteries. And with the torque, you actually have to power some crafting stations like the advanced Fiber working station. Where is it? Yeah, advanced fiber working station. It actually needs power from what I understand. Well, actually let's unpack the base because I want you to see how it looks when it's unpacked again. As a little warning, it might be a little harder to find a location for the base than originally. Let's see how it looks now. Okay, yeah. Make sure you have a lot of doors on it because depending on where you put it, it might not be accessible from certain directions. I mean the doors. Yeah, that might be a problem. So everything is here and safe as you can see. Ta-da! And now you're ready to leave the map. So be careful, you need to do a lot of preparation and you can also do it using only one walker because your team members can ride on your walker and the rest can put their walkers in the lobby. So don't forget about that. No, too close to a base for transfer. Probably it's that base. Also, I'm using the ballista slot instead of the steering wheel. Well, if you have any more questions, you can just ask in the comments because I plan on building another base in another oasis, but for now, we'll just have to see where it goes. Let's see how far you have to be from the base, including the base packed in your walker, to transfer to the lobby. Stop. Stop. Okay, now it's working. Anyway, and then you can just use the walkers in your lobby and spawn them back in. See you next time. Bye.